when you are trading in this news, we have the previous figures, we have the forecast and the actual. What? The previous figures are exactly those figures that were released the previous month. Okay? Then there is the forecast. The forecast, which some book called the consensus, is basically the figures that are expected. Other analysts are expecting, in other words, because they need to normally sit down, the analysts sit down, okay, and they speculate intellectualize what may be the result for that particular news based upon certain factors. You get it?
Mm-hmm.
They based on this, based on unemployment, they look at certain figures based upon how the economy is doing, and they can normally project that. Because of this and this and such and such a factor, we expect news to come like what? Like this. So the people that trade normally, before news has been released, they based on the previous and the what? For them, they enter with that. You get it? So it's just a comparison. For me to know whether this is taller than him, I just need to know his height and his... I do the comparison, I know that this one is taller than this one. So the same thing applies. If the news that is going to come, let's say the CPI that is coming, the previous one was low and the actual one, the forecast is high, what am I expected to do then? The guys that will come in, let's say for the CPI M sub M, this one, right? This one. These guys will do what? Will sell the what? They will sell the dollar. Because for them, they focus on, I'll say we have the previous, we have forecast, and we also have actual. So the guys that trade before will focus, let's say, on 0.1001. When we look at the previous figures, these figures are higher than? Yet we know that if the CPI comes and it's higher than the previous one, it is good news, yes? When it comes and it's lower than the previous one, it's what? So for this case, what do we have? We have good or we have bad news? We have bad, therefore we are supposed to sell. We are supposed to sell the what? So the guys that trade before this news has been released are apparently wait for this day to reach, which is on Wednesday in the morning, or immediately the European guys open, that is at around 11. For them, they will start selling the what? Because they know generally the economy is not doing what? So when they come to such a pair, USD stroke what? How do you treat this? Because you know that you are supposed to sell the what? And you're supposed to do what? Technically, what would you do to this whole pair? What would you do to this whole pair? Do you buy this pair or you sell this pair?
Buy.
How many are saying you buy? How many are saying you sell? How many don't know? I think I'm about to say, where have you been? Maybe you're here and not here. What do you think? Are we buying this pair or we are selling this pair? This is where the challenge comes in. You've analyzed your pair properly. You've analyzed your market what? Properly. Mm-hmm. But finally, how are you going to treat it? On the market, when you come to the market like this, how will you be in position to sell this dollar? So do you go there and buy and sell at the same time?
No.
What do you do?
I buy the Japanese yen.
You buy the Japanese yen. How?
Because this one is not even buying.
So what do you do to the whole pair?
Sell it.
So we have two pairs. We have this. So this is where we know who is grabbing and who is understanding. But all you know that you're supposed to do what?
Five.
Say the what? And this one will be what? So if you're now this guy that has analyzed this market, what would you do then if you come to the market? Hello?
I buy that.
So which direction do you expect this market to go? Up or down?
Down.
How many are saying up? How many are saying it's down?
Down.
Which one should we take?
Down.
So we expect this one to go where?
Down.
We expect this player to go? Okay, let's do it practically. When you look at the Forex Bureau, they normally have something like this, a whiteboard.
Yeah.
When the dollar, let's say, Uganda shilling, USD what? Uganda shilling, because this is how our chart looks like, literally the same way, all together. They normally say $1 equals to? Let's take this. Meaning this pair is what? That's why we use pairs. Normally the US dollar is what?
One.
Which is the best? The best is always?
One.
Also the same thing applies here. When you go to your chart, you don't see the euros there. The only price you will see, it will be for that what?
One.
For the quote. Okay?
Yes.
Peace. Are we together? We are together. Normally what these guys do, let's assume, normally what these guys do, when this dollar loses value, what do? They rub, let's say they put three what? Three, four, all together. They rub it. But because our charts are digital, we shall not do what? It will, instead, the price will instead be where? It will be there. So perhaps we are not trapping. What will happen to the market? The candles will just come where? It means that here, the dollar is what? It's gaining value now at this price. It's losing what? And the shilling is what? The shilling is gaining. So, when the best is losing value, that's when the market goes where?
Down.
So maybe for us to profit out of this movement, we'll be selling the dollar and we'll be buying the Uganda shilling. Why is it gaining value yet the market is moving down? It's because the very dollar that you needed more shilling to buy, this time round you need less
shilling.
Therefore, the country or the currency is gaining value. The same concept comes here. When you are selling the best, we are expecting the market to go where? Therefore, what do we do for us to profit when the market is going down?
Sell.
So for us to make profits, it will mean that we are selling this and automatically buying the one that is gaining value. But our main emphasis is the what? So for someone who trade this pair, they will instead just do what? They will sell. And what will the person be trading this do?
Buy.
You will?
Buy.
Because when we are buying, we assume that this first currency or the best currency is gaining what? Which is the euro. And this one is losing? So, someone who is trading this will sell the pair or sell the market, and the one that will be trading this will be buying the market. Yet, both of these people will be selling the dollar. The task we have is to know how to treat that particular pair, that particular currency when it comes to the pair. Hello? Yes? So it's not a matter of you analyzing. You may do your analysis here. You come here and you do what? You fail to put a trade. Then you'll be like, am I buying, am I saving? You start that. Begin to make your proper analysis. This is how guys do trade news before it has been released trade. They normally come in where the most population appropriate to that time comes in, and that's when they put in their trade. And the exact appropriate population that normally comes in before that news is normally the European session. So they come in during the opening of the European session at 11 a.m. Okay? The guys that trade when news is being released, because when this news will be released, the actual figures will also be put where? So the guys that trade when news is being released, for them they come to the market, they don't need to know. All they need to know is how impactful this news will be. That's when we come in the 20th rule of the deviation. The 30th rule of the deviation says that if the forecast, if the is more than 20% of the deviation, then trade in the direction of the deviation. Are we together? Do you get that? If the forecasted figures are more than 20% of the deviation, then trade in the direction of the deviation. What do we mean? Look at the previous figures, okay? And look at the forecasted figures. Get to know, are you getting more value? Are you getting more lower value? For if this needs to be impacting, if these figures in the forecasted figures are more than 20% of the forecast, you get it? So, get the forecast, get this 20%, okay? Actually, get 20% of the what? Of the previous figures, right? Get 20% of the previous figures, okay? Add 20% of the previous figures to see if it is, in other words, this is what it means. That if the forecasted figures is more than 20% of the previous figures, you get it? 20% of, if the forecast is more by 20% of the previous figures, Mumpuna, yeah? Then it means that that is going to be impacting. If it's also less by 20%, less more by 20%, then you still do what? Expect it to be what? Impacted. Because there is a very big difference or deviation. So that alone will also mean that this news is going to be impacted. Minus the red flag. Because it may reflect a red flag, but then there is the deviation that is there is very small. Therefore, it may not be so or very impactive. If it goes for 100 pips, it will mean that we'd have made $1,000. And normally this takes 1 minute for it to move. But still you also have to protect this. When you put yourself stop order here, make sure you put the stop loss where? There, and for this you also put the stop loss where? Because they are times whereby you will not get this. But when you get it, you get profits relative to a deviation of 1 to 6. That if you risk $10, you may get $60 back, having risked 10 what? Sorry, having risked $10. Are we together? We are looking at trader number what? Do we pick it? So, The only challenging thing here is to measure the number of pips and secondly, to put these orders, the buy stop and the sell, and to give them the stop, because we're going to do that practically, don't worry. I'll show you how we put the buy stop orders and the sell stop orders, the pending orders, because we have different types of orders. We have the buy orders, sell orders, stop loss order, take profit order, buy stop order, sell stop order, buy limit order, sell limit order, trading stop order, and so on and so forth. There are so many, but those are the main common ones, if they are not the only ones. Peace. Are we together?
No. Stop now. Our spouse.
I'll give you both the hardest way and the easiest way of putting these orders.
I just want to
Okay?
Okay.
Then, the remaining person is the person that trades after news has been. We say we have different ways in which we can treat this news. And before you trade this news, you need to know what exactly it means when it comes, when the fears are, because there are situations whereby the news will come and the figures are high, but this time around it's the negative issue, right? The way we treat unemployment is not the same way we treat the interest rates, it's not the same way we treat the GDP. When the GDP figures come and they are high, that is good news. When the unemployment figures come and they are high, that is what? That is bad news. So before you trade news, you need to first know what exactly that news means. Okay? So the people that trade after the actual figures have been released, for them, they don't want to get that impact or that normally volatility movements that are in the market during that news release. Because when you go to the markets, you realize that around 6 or 4, because yesterday I checked when there were no those volatility at around 1 in the night or in the morning. But only to wake up, that's when I saw those moves. I was like, man, what has got this move? Because the rest of the world had not actually paid attention that they may be the new, those impacts. Only to realize in the morning that we expected, we saw those impacts. So the European guys have gotten to wake up only to be surprised with such movements in the market. Okay? Okay? So the guys that trade after those big impacts, first of all, they need to know how impactful this news is going to be. Okay? How impactful this news is going to be. What do I mean? They look at the deviation between the actual and the forecasted figures. You get it? If the actual figures that are released are more than 20% of the forecasted figures, then we expect to trade in the direction of the deviation. Are we together? What does this mean? This means that when the actual figures that have come are more than 20%, of the forecasted figures, then we are supposed to trade in the direction of the deviation, therefore we are supposed to buy. Are we together? Then if it's the opposite, we are supposed to do what?
Yes.
Sell. So we just need to wait for the actual figures that are released. If they are more than 20% of the deviation, in other words, you have to add 20% of that any figure that has to be released as your actual figure. Check it. You add 20%. If this figure is still valid and is still more than 20% of the deviation, then expect to do what? Buy. Are you together? And then if it's the opposite, you do what? Based upon the news that has come. You place the stop loss, like I'll give you a clear strategy on how to trade it, like when you are trading this news, okay? So, these guys buy and sell after they have seen. seen the actual figures that if the GDP has increased, for them they wait not until they really see the actual figures, they have increased. Because sometimes the actual figures that we see here, they are not the exact ones that are revealed after the actual figures come. Sometimes they are the same, sometimes there is a slight difference, okay? So the guys that come after news has been released come out with the exact values and they trade them off. The strategy I'll give you is called off the top, which actually tells you of the whole procedures of how you can buy, you can sell based upon news. Off the top.